What's up, everybody? It's your boy. It's Elliot. Welcome back to another take here at Esports with Elrod. We are 3 days away from Call of Duty's next big reveal, Call of Duty Next. During this Call of Duty Next reveal, I kind of expect to see the new innovations that are coming. That means the explanation of a lack of slide canceling in addition to dolphin diving. And from what we see, this dash mechanic and the AI breakdown of how Call of Duty is going to be working on developing their AI system.
Modern Warfare 2's AI is systemic. What that means is that when you play it, you're engaging with it in a different way almost every time. If you react in a certain way or if you move in a certain way, the AI will react to you in a different way.
The first thing that we do is just start researching to see, like, what do people do in real life when they face this situation. We were looking at improving soldier speed during combat. In previous games, the AI felt like they were not appreciating their life, but in the new game, it feels like they are stressed out about the situation when they have to run somewhere.
When I hear this, I think of the old Lord of the Rings game where every time that you combated somebody, they remember how you played. So if you were very aggressive and came at them with a lot of swords, they brought in shields, they would have bows, or be in a more ranged attack, so it would be more difficult to accomplish your more aggressive style. I don't know if that's exactly how this is going to be, but that's just the first thing that comes to my mind when I hear this. However, we got the big reveal today that during the beta weekends, we're going to have a battle pass, kind of, that you can unlock and earn these cosmetics and blueprints. When the release of Modern Warfare 2 comes out, you can actually use these. As we all know, during the beta weekends, the progress that you make with leveling up your weapons or operators is just for that weekend. You never get the XP that you put on your weapons during the beta weekend at the launch game. Everyone gets a clean slate. But what's cool is if you do play the beta, you get a reward for it with unlocking cosmetics that you're not going to be able to get in-game, only for the beta. I think that's pretty cool. They're building in their own exclusivity with this. So first, you unlock at level 2 this emblem. And I've been seeing this emblem in the countdown promotional stuff that they've been doing. It's been floating in the background. So it makes me wonder if this is actually a game mode or a perk or something we're seeing coming to Call of Duty next. The next one at level 4 is going to be a weapon charger called Buckled Up. And it's this ragdoll one. And I hope that really this ragdoll one isn't fixed in this position and that all of the little appendages can move around, because I think that'd be pretty funny just to see flop around. Then, to keep it even, from level 2 to level 4 to now level 6, we get the player card, and we get an animated player card that's passed the test. I think this is dope. I love these player cards, the animated ones. I think they're pretty cool. Then at level 10, we get a sticker. I'm not the biggest fan of stickers, but it is what it is. They have to put something in there. Then at level 15, we get the weapon blueprint side impact, which kind of looks like a pistol, but it also could be like an Uzi. I'm not too sure exactly what this is, but I'm excited for it. And if you look at the details on this, it says beta. I think this is really cool. And then going into the second weekend, you can work on getting the operator, a sticker, a vehicle skin, and then another weapon blueprint. This probably is going to be like for the M4A1 or whatever that version of the gun is from the Modern Warfare 2019 game. But I love it. I think this one is sick. Going from reverse now, the vehicle is interesting, because are we going to see this in the DMZ or Warzone 2, maybe for Ground War or something? One criticism that I've had for all of the Modern Warfare games or Call of Duty games since 2019 is the lack of, like, the vehicle skins that you could buy in-game translated to Warzone, especially in Cold War, where there was boats and jet skis and nobody ever got to use them. So I would like to see more use of vehicle skins. We got a sticker. Y'all know how I feel about the sticker. The vinyl. I don't know what that is. A vinyl. Huh. I'm wondering if this is like a... different than a player card. I'm curious. What is the vinyl going to be? Let me know in the comments what you think the vinyl sticker is going to be. It's called No Competition. I like it. Fuck with it. And then, but this operator skin, we can get a better look at it right here. I think this looks amazing. It's kind of optic gaming themed, which makes it even more tough in my opinion. And I'm going to be doing everything in my power to unlock this. You could bet your bottom dollar. I think this whole game looks good. It looks like he's holding an M4A1. They're not going to tease anything with the gun right there. But I think this operator looks good. I'm excited. I'm so thankful that I pre-ordered this, because the hype around Modern Warfare 2 is just off the charts. The last thing I wanted to touch up on was probably the news that came around Halo. It's probably the biggest news around Halo since Halo Infinite. And that is Bonnie Ross has officially left 343. Her official statement reads, "While I had hoped to stay with Halo until we released the winter update, I'm letting you know that I will be leaving 343 and attending a family medical issue. I am incredibly proud of work everyone at 343 Industries has done with Halo Infinite, the Master Chief Collection, Halo TV series, and so much more. It has been an honor to serve alongside the team the last 15 be a part of the universe that I love. Thank you to everyone in the Halo community for your support. Halo's future is bright. I wait for all of you to experience what we have in store here alongside you as a fan at the Halo World Championship in October. Axios, Bonnie Ross. That's right. The Fire 343 movement actually worked, and they got rid of the head of 343. Bonnie Ross has officially stepped down. Now, she does state that it is for a medical issue, and I don't want to comment on that, but this does kind of read as like a corporate letter of her just getting fired without getting fired. So this actually gives me hope that somebody can don the Chief's helmet and lead Halo Infinite to a bright future. With everything going on, I'm very curious on how the Halo community is going to rally around all of this. This is where we're going to wrap up the video. Thank you for watching one of my daily dives into the gaming and esports scene. If you want 7 years of good luck and a picture of a cute dog, make sure to like this video, smash the subscribe button so hard that the little notification bell gets turned on, and share this with a friend who loves gaming and esports as much as we do. Thank you for doing so. Here's a picture of my cute dog, Annie the Labradoodle. He goes literally everywhere with me. If you want to play games with me, follow me over on Twitch, twitch.tv/esportswithElrod. I stream most days around 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so let's plan it out either on Discord or Twitter. Links down below. With that being said, that's where we're going to wrap up the video for today. Make somebody laugh today. I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.